Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the Syncfusion Blazor Input Mask component. Using the Input Mask component, you can mask and validate numeric values in standard input fields. You can let users enter valid data like phone numbers, date values, credit card numbers, and other standard format values. In this video, I'll explain how easy it is to add a Syncfusion Blazor Input Mask component to a Blazor WebAssembly application and show you how to configure a few of its basic features, specifically data binding, mask configuration, and the supported native events. To explore the other features of the Blazor Input Mask component, refer to the website link shown in the above card. Let me start with the application creation process. I can create a Blazor application using either Visual Studio 2019 or Visual Studio Code. In this video, I'll show you how to create a Blazor WebAssembly application using Visual Studio 2019. Make sure that you have installed it along with .NET Core, SDK 3.1.3 or later. Now, open Visual Studio 2019 and choose Create a New Project from the dashboard. Select Blazor App from the templates and click the Next button. I'll name my project and click Create. Here, I will choose the Blazor WebAssembly app and click the Create button. The project has been created and is ready for use. If you want to know more about the Blazor WebAssembly app and how to add Syncfusion components to it, then you can check video link in the above card. Now, I will show you the step-by-step process for adding an input mask to this project. First, I need to install the necessary Syncfusion Blazor packages. For that, I'll open the NuGet package manager, search for Syncfusion Blazor, and install it in my application. Once installed, you can see the Blazor packages are being added to this application's packages folder. To work with an input mask component, first I'll navigate to the imports.razor page and import the namespace Syncfusion Blazor inputs. Next, I'll open the program.cs file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then I'll register the Syncfusion Blazor service by calling the method addSyncfusionBlazor inside the main method. Also, I should register the valid license key in my application, so let me register the trial license key using the registerLicense method. Then I will navigate to the index.html page within the root folder to add a CSS reference from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. The configuration steps are done. So let me continue to add the Blazor input mask now. For that, I'll open the index component and include the div tag with a few CSS styles to align the input mask component. I add the SF masquerade text box tag within this div element. Next, I want to add a label here. So let me define a div element with a value set to mobile number. I will also define the property placeholder with the value enter a 10-digit number, which will be displayed as an int in the input mask component. See in the output, the input mask component is rendered with a short description enter a 10-digit number. To start validating the user input, I may need to use the mask property. Now, I will remove the placeholder property from the Blazor input mask tag to show you the standard mask values using the mask property. Then I will add the mask property and assign a standard mask element which allows user to enter a single digit numbers ranging from 0 to 9. You can refer to the documentation page link shared in the description part to learn about the built-in standard mask elements. So here you can see that in the input mask component, I can enter numbers between 0 and 9. Next, I will show you how to bind data to the input mask. You can do this in two different ways, one-way binding and two-way binding. I'm going to show you one-way binding. First, I need to add @code directive to populate the data. Then I will define the variable mask value of type string with a 9-digit number value. I will assign this variable mask value to the value property of the input mask component. Look at the output page now. The input mask component displays the given 9-digit number value. Now I will show you how to bind data to the input mask through two-way binding. Two-way binding can be achieved by using the bind value attribute. It supports the data types string, input, enum, date time, and boolean. To achieve this, I will change value property to bind value attribute. Let me show you how to bind this input mask value to a paragraph tag. I include a paragraph tag and then I'll bind the same mask value variable here. You can see the input mask and paragraph rendered with the same provided 9-digit value. When I change the value in the input mask, it will be reflected in the paragraph also. This is how the two-way binding works in an input mask. Next, I will show you how to set the custom mask elements. For better clarity, I will remove the bind value attribute and comment the quotes related to it. I'm going to display a time value, so let me declare a variable called custom mask value of object type with the key fields as P and M and set the appropriate values to it. And then I assign this variable custom mask value to the custom characters property. Then I need to change the mask property value to the time value. I want to display the appropriate placeholder text for the input mask component. So I will remove this div element and add the placeholder property with a text value. Look at the output. Now I can enter a time value based on the custom mask set to it. Next, I will show you how to set a regular expression. Before I set the regular expression, I'll remove the custom characters property and comment its related quotes. Then I include the property float label type to show the label on the top while typing the value and set its value to auto. Here I'm going to get the 4-digit ATM pin number. So let me set an appropriate regular expression for this mask property. Along with this, I also change the placeholder text to enter pin code. So here you can see the component and I can enter the pin code value like this. I can allow to enter only digits range from 0 to 9. Now I will show you how to add the prom characters to the mask elements. I want to add a hash character to mask elements. So first I will include the prom character property and set its value to hash. Look at the output now. The prom character hash is being shown in the input mask component. Finally, I will show you how to bind events to the input mask. Here, you can find the list of native events supported in the component like onClick, onBlur, onFocus, onKeyPress, and so on. I will show you a simple example using the onKeyPress event, which triggers when I press a key on the keyboard with the current focus being set on the input mask element. First, I will add the value property in the input mask tag and uncomment its related code. Then I add onKeyPressEvent to the input mask component and assign the callback method changeValueOnKeyPress. Inside this callback method, I will change the value of input mask. Look at the input mask now. When I press any key, its value will change to the new static value passed inside the callback method. Now, let me make a quick summary of what we have seen so far. I have shown you how to create a Blazor WebAssembly app and add an input mask component to it. And then I showed you a few of its basic features, specifically data binding, mask configuration, and the supported native events. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description of this video below. You can also look into getting a free license key to use our Blazor products if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.